He survived. His wife did not. Tonight, a family torn apart by these flames. And Channel 4 Action News reporter Keith Jones, tonight you talked to the members of this devastated family.
Yes, I did. The husband is here at Mercy Hospital right now. He suffered severe burns to his arm and also to his face when he was trying to rescue his wife, who was trapped inside that home. And tragically, tonight, she never made it out. This is what's left of the home on Ferndale Avenue. Firefighters had to lower it to get to the elderly victim inside. Across the street, her family and friends gathered to pray. Hours earlier, a viewer snapped this picture of the fire at its worst. When it sparked, the fire chief tells me an elderly man was in the backyard, his wife inside the house.
We believe she was on the first floor and the first floor collapsed.
Fire Chief William Davis Jr. has known the family his whole life. When he arrived, he saw neighbors restraining the elderly man who was frantically trying to save his wife. His arms and face were severely burned.
He wanted to get in the house really bad, and my dad had to hold him back.
Firefighters never made it into the house. The man's wife was pronounced dead. I spoke with their emotional niece.
It's not a way that you would want somebody to pass on, but we are strong believers. The family is a family of strong believers. We believe she's with the Lord.
Firefighters say the fire may have started with a kerosene heater in the basement. The elderly woman leaves behind three children and a whole lot of loved ones.
She'd have a conversation with you, but if you got out of line, she'd snatch you right back up. So very feisty.
I'm heartbroken for the family, for myself, for everyone. She was a wonderful person in our community.
Now, the fire marshal has not yet determined exactly what caused this fire. The medical examiner's office here in the county has yet to identify this woman. For now, we're live at Mercy Hospital. Keith Jones, Channel 4 Action News.